Tokozani, good day everyone, please welcome back. This is Gogo Makhabo again. Thank you so much guys for tuning in, and I also want to welcome those who are new. Please remember to subscribe, like our page, hit the notification bell, and if you really like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you. Okay guys, I want us to do our reading for this week. Let's see what's coming to us this week. This is the weekly prediction. Let's see what's coming to us. We're going to check anything about money, anything about things which will bring money into our lives, our career, our business. I have the High Priestess. We're going to check on money. Will money come into our life this week? I have the Cups. What about relationships? The Three of Wands. The Knight of Swords. The Knight of Pentacles. Any distractions? Any opportunities coming to us this week? I have two cards. Nine of Pentacles. The Empress in reversal. The King of Pentacles. The Six of Wands. The Star. The Hanged Man in reversal. The Five of Pentacles. The King of Pentacles. The Four of Swords. The Page of Pentacles. The Three of Wands. Okay. And for those of you who believe in previous lives, if you believe that your soul is an old soul, if you believe that you've been reincarnated, let's see what happened in one of your past lives, which is affecting your current situation. Trust and faith in reversal. Let's get another card. Living or traveling. The third card. Male or female. Okay. I have the Three of Wands. I have the High Priestess. And I have the Page. The Page of Pentacles. Okay, when coming to work, anything about business, anything which will bring you money in your life, they say to you that, yes, you are doing very well, you'll do very well this week, and you feel like expanding your knowledge, you want to learn more, you feel like traveling, most of you, maybe you want to apply to, you know, jobs which are far from home, maybe abroad, things like that. Here they say to you that they're talking to you, through your intuition. Your guides are telling you that you need to listen to that intuition. They're guiding you. When you start having these creative ideas, you start having these feelings which are like pushing you to do something different in your life, you need to know that these are your guides. They want you to, you know, start exploring more, start expanding your wings. There are so many things waiting for you out there. Do not be satisfied with what you have right now. You need to want more, okay? For some of you, maybe you might feel like you want to go back to school, or you want to further your studies, or you're still doing that right now. This is a very good thing because this is going to bring you abundance in future. And then they said to you that for those of you who are like looking for a job or something, they said to you that yes, this is the right time to start applying. Submit your CVs wherever you can submit them. And if you have this thing of, having your own business, it means that this is the right time to start doing that. Do your research and then start wherever you can start, okay? They said that a very excellent opportunity is awaiting you. It's waiting for you, and yes, this opportunity will come to you this week. They said to you that you're going to hear happy news, good news. This is about your career. Maybe it can be a promotion, maybe it can be salary adjustment, something like that. These are things which will bring you money in your life. Or for those of you who are still studying, maybe you want a scholarship, you want a bursary or something. This week you'll get good news, you'll get something. Even if it's someone giving you some money to study further to pay for your fees. Okay, now let's move on to any challenges, distractions, or any opportunities coming your way this week. Okay, things which you are capable of doing. What is it? Okay, they say to you that this week you are going to celebrate. There's something which you're going to celebrate about. Maybe this is about the work that you've done in the past. This is you getting an award or something. Even if they say that you're gonna celebrate, but it seems as if whatever you're going to celebrate is not going to bring money immediately. If there's money attached to it, this money will come later on in life, not right now. And then they said to you that you must not forget to send gratitude to the divine. Even if whatever is coming to you, that good news is coming to you, and this is not what you were expecting. Maybe you were expecting more money on it or something on it. But even if it's a small thing, just send gratitude to the divine. And then they said to you that more peace is coming to you, because in the past there were many challenges, there were many arguments, disagreements here and there, but this time, lots of peace will come to you. You'll feel at peace this week. You'll feel at peace this week. You'll feel very happy. Okay? And then they say to you that as you feel at peace, you feel joy and content in your heart. This is a way of you of attracting good luck from the universe. They say to you that prosperity is coming to you. Okay? And if, like, maybe there were some arguments when coming to your relationships, they said to you that this week you're going to resolve those arguments with your partner. Or it can be a friend or it can be a family member, but you're going to resolve those arguments. Meaning that this is the time for you to forgive and let go. Okay, forgive and forget. Okay. And let's come to relationship. Let's see what's coming to us about the relationship. Okay, when coming to relationship, this is a very good week for you. They say to you that this is the week to, just forget the bad things which has happened to you. Forget those who has wronged you in the past. Sometimes you find that maybe you are in that relationship where you feel like your partner is a, energy vampire, something like that, and you are giving too much energy on it. That's why you are losing some money sometimes. That's why you don't attract those good things from the universe anymore, because you are putting lots of your energy on that. Those arguments, you are feeling hurt, things like that. They say to you that this is the week for you to start balancing things. Forgive this person. You need to realize who this person is. And then if you continue staying with this person, yes, it's still okay because this is your choice, it's your will. And but what you need to do is to make sure that you forgive this person, and you need to make sure that you need to know how to control your energy. Do not let this person suck your energy, your good energy, okay? Because the more they suck it is, the more that you are attracting bad luck. And they say to you that you need to continue loving yourself, put yourself first, don't let anyone manipulate you. And they say to you that this is the time for you to start planning for the long term, start planning for the future. And they said to you that yes, there were some choices which you made in the past, and those choices, they're going to affect your current situation. They're going to affect your relationship right now. They're also going to affect your abundance, your money as well. And then they said to you that from now on, you need to be patient as you decide what you need to do next, okay? You make sure that now you start planning your things. Okay, now let's come to money. I have the Knight of Pentacles, King of Pentacles, the Nine of Pentacles, the Five of Pentacles, and the King of Pentacles. Okay, abundance is coming to you this week. You're going to celebrate. You'll receive some money from somewhere, even if this money doesn't come this week, but it will come in the following weeks. You're going to get abundance, meaning that whatever you're doing right now, whatever you're planning right now, however you are, you're protecting your good energy, these are the things which are going to bring you abundance, financial gain in future. They say to you that the problem with you is that sometimes you allow negative thoughts to manifest in you. This is the time for you to start getting rid of those negative thoughts because they are becoming real. They are bringing challenges into your life. And they say to you that, yes, you do have fear about money. You need to get rid of that fear. Yes, you might have many things going on, maybe some debts, fees for your children to pay and other things. You have a lot to carry on your shoulders. And this is because of the fear that you have about money. You are always worried about money. How are you going to get out of those debts? You are so worried about those things. Sometimes just be positive. Tell yourself that you're going to receive money from the universe. How will this money come to you? That's up to the universe. Do not worry about it. But tell yourself that you are manifesting money every day through thin air. Okay? And this is because maybe some of you, those who are business-minded, maybe you have this business and you feel like things are not going well. Do not worry, things are going to pick up. And then they still encourage you to be compassionate, show love to others, continue loving yourself. And then they say to you that great success is coming to you. You will have financial security and prosperity. And which means that you also need to start right now, start saving that money, okay? Or investing if you like investing. Everything will turn out beautifully this week. You'll see that everything looks positive, which means that you are planning correctly, you are on the right track as well, and you're getting support from the universe, from your guides as well. And yes, they say to you that someone out there, it can be your spouse, it can be a parent, it can be a friend or a colleague, they will show you support as well on whatever you're doing. Okay? For whatever was said on this reading, let's see what is affecting our current situation right now. If you believe that your soul is an old soul, you've been reincarnated over and over, what is affecting your present situation? What happened in the past which is affecting your life right now? When I'm talking about affecting, I'm talking about maybe this thing is affecting your relationship. You want to feel loved and wanted, you want to get married, or you are married but things are not going good in your marriage. This will also be something which is also affecting your money as well. You're working very hard to get your money, but you're not satisfied with what you're getting. Or even if you are satisfied, but the thing is, the money comes in, tomorrow it is gone. You don't know what's happening around you. What is it? Why can't you attract this money? Why can't you attract this abundance? You are looking for work and you can't find work. What is it? What is blocking your luck to get this job that you want to get? Okay. Okay, they said to you that yes, maybe in the past you were a female or you were a male. It's okay. Yes, it's possible that you might find that in your past life you were a female. Now in this present lifetime you are a male figure. Okay, it's possible. Vice versa. Okay, and they said to you that the thing with you is that in the past you were lacking trust. So when you lack trust, obviously you won't be able to attract good things into your life. So when you don't attract good things into your life, it means that your generation, your coming generation is affected as well. even in this present lifetime, you might find that you still have that thing of not trusting in yourself, trusting in other people, not trusting in the universe, not having the faith. So here with trust, it can be you not trusting other people or not trusting yourself, having that low self-esteem, or maybe it might be you not trusting on your, you know, on the universe, not trusting on your guides, on your ancestor guides. It can be this. It can be the thing which is affecting you right now. Maybe you've stopped believing. Something happened also in one of your past lives which made you to stop believing. Okay? Or you didn't stop believing. The thing is that whatever was happening, you know, something happened, something very bad, which made you to be afraid to start believing in your ancestor guides, in the spiritual guides. And they said to you that in the past, you were traveling a lot. You might find that the work that you were doing, you were traveling a lot. So you were spending most of your time away from your family. And this was weighing heavily on you. You were always feeling nostalgic, you know, homesickness. And this is affecting you right now. That's why you might find that most of you don't want change in your life. You are afraid of change. If there's anything which is bringing change in your life, you are afraid of it. You are afraid of applying for jobs which are far from home. You are afraid of traveling because of what happened in the past. Maybe in the past there was a time that you had to travel and something very bad happened. Maybe that was something which took your life in the past. So that's why now you are afraid of traveling far. You are afraid of changes. You are afraid of exploring. Remember, they said to you that you need to start expanding your wings if you want to be successful in this life. Okay? So this is our reading for this week, and I hope it will resonate with you. I hope you'll learn one or two things. And if you feel like this message about the past, it is really affecting you, or it does resonate with you, you need to make sure that you start making changes right now. You start believing in the universe. You start believing in the Almighty God. You start believing in yourself. You need to kill that low self-esteem. You need to kill that fear. And by so doing, you'll be able to find your purpose in this lifetime. Thank you so much, guys, and have a lovely week.